We are now ready to discuss the most difficult challenge in applications of hidden Markov models, how to find out the parameters of the HMM. So far, we have assumed that the transition and emission probabilities of the HMM are known. For example, when you walked in the crooked casino, you knew that the dealer changes the coins with probabilities 0.1, and you also knew the biases of both fair and biased coin. However, imagine that you only know that the crook dealer is using two coins and know nothing else, know nothing about probabilities of biased and fair coins or probabilities of changing between coins. Suppose you observe the sequence. How can you figure out what are the biases of the coins and how often the dealer changes the coin? Can we develop an algorithm for parameter estimation for an arbitrary HMM? Let's start answering this difficult question from the unlikely scenario when the dealer reveals what is the hidden path. In this case, we will face HMM parameter estimation problem, find optimal parameters explaining the emitted string and the hidden path. So hidden path and emitted string are given at the bottom of the slide. How would we derive transition and emission probabilities? In the case the hidden path is known, let's define TLK as the number of transitions from state L to state K in the hidden path pi. For example, in this case, the number of transitions from B to F equal to 5. And then common sense suggests us that the transition probabilities from state L to state K can be defined as the number of transitions from state L to state K divided by the number of all transitions from state L, and in this case it will be 5/9. Now, after we define the number, the probability of transition from state L to state K, let's now estimate the emission probability of symbol B into from state K, and to do this, let's define the parameter EKB, number of times symbol B is emitted when path pi is in state K. In our case, EFT will be equal to 6, and the common sense again suggests to define emission probability of symbol B from state K as the number of times symbol B is emitted in state K divided by the total number of symbols emitted in state K. In our case, it's 6/11. It turned out that transition and emission probabilities defined in this way define the optimal solution of the HMM parameter estimation problem. However, the real problem we are trying to solve is the problem when dealer is not that generous, so neither hidden path nor parameters are known, and it results in HMM parameter learning problem. More difficult problem than HMM parameter estimation problem. In HMM parameter learning problem, we need to estimate the parameters of an HMM explaining an emitted string. Only the emitted string is known. So let's try the following algorithm for solving this problem. We are only given emitted string, but let's start from an arbitrary wild guess of parameters. As soon as we guess the parameter, we can derive hidden path by solving the decoding problem. As soon as hidden path is known, we can pretend that we don't know the parameter, and we can solve HMM parameter estimation problem deriving a new set of parameters. Afterwards, we can once again forget about the hidden path we have constructed and use emitted string and new set of parameters to derive the new hidden path and iterate. This algorithm is called Viterbi Learning for HMM. The deficiency of the Viterbi Learning is that it is based on the Viterbi algorithm that gives a strict yes or no answer to the question, was the HMM in state K at time I, given that it emitted string X? This question fails to account for how certain we are in the yes or no answer. And in the next section, we'll try to design a soft answer to this question and design a new parameter learning algorithm that improves on the Viterbi learning.